JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for September the 15th. I am Charalambos, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all the other G10 currencies on Monday and during the Asian morning Tuesday. It underperformed the most versus the Aussie, the Yen, the Euro and the Pound in that order, while it lost the least ground versus the Canadian dollar and NOK. The weakening of the US dollar combined with the strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie suggests that markets traded in a risk-on fashion yesterday. However, the fact that the yen was among the main gainers points otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, major EU indices traded within a narrow range of plus minus 0.15%, with the only exception being the French CAC 40, which gained 0.35%. That said, investors' appetite improved during the US session, perhaps due to signs of progress in the development of a potential coronavirus vaccine, as well as by several multi-billion-dollar deals. Drug maker AstraZeneca resumed its UK clinical trials after being suspended last week, while Pfizer and BioNTech proposed to expand their phase 3 vaccine trial to about 44,000 participants. With regards to the deals, Nvidia Corp announced plans to buy the UK-based chip designer Arm from Japan's SoftBank Group Corp for as much as $14 billion, while Oracle said it would team up with China's ByteDance to keep TikTok operating in the US in a deal structured as a partnership rather than an outright sale. The upbeat morale rolled over into the Asian session today as well, aided by the better than expected Chinese data. Industrial production accelerated to 5.6% year-over-year from 4.8% instead of growing 5.1% as the forecast suggested, while retail sales rebounded 0.5% year-over-year from minus 1.1%, beating estimates of 0.1%. Fixed asset investment was also slightly better than anticipated, as it slid less than anticipated. Here, the exception is Japan's Nikkei 225, which slid 0.50% even after Japan's chief cabinet secretary, Yoshihide Suga, won the governing's party election. Suga seems to be in favor of Abenomics, and thus his election is a positive for the stock market in our view. Maybe Nikkei slid on a sell-the-fact reaction, as Suga was widely anticipated to win. In any case, we don't expect the slide to last for long. We see these are chances for Nikkei to rebound soon. Actually, as we noted in the past, we see decent chances for the broader appetite to improve for the most of the major stock indices and for the most of the major stock indices to continue drifting north, which with major central banks and governments willing to do whatever it takes to support the global economy, and with headlines over a potential vaccine coming on the bright side, we believe that the path for least resistance for equities and other risk-linked assets may be to the upside. At the same time, safe havens like the US dollar and the yen may come under renewed selling interest. We repeat that among our favorite pairs for gauging the broader market sentiment are the Aussie dollar and the Aussie yen, as they consist of a risk-linked currency and a safe haven one. Therefore, when investors are optimistic, these pairs tend to trade higher, while the opposite may be true during periods of fear or cautiousness. Now, as for today's events, during the European morning, the UK employment report for July is coming out. The unemployment rate is forecast to have ticked up to 4% from 3.9%, while average weekly earnings, including bonuses, are anticipated to have fallen at a faster pace than in June. Specifically, the year-over-year earnings rate is expected to have ticked down to minus 1.3% from minus 1.2%. The excluding bonuses rate is forecast to have held steady at minus 0.2% year-over-year. That said, according to the KPMG and REC UK report on jobs, starting and temporary pay fell markedly, but with the rates of decline easing since June. In our view, this shifts the risks of the earnings rates somewhat to the upside. That said, we expect pound traders to keep their gaze locked on developments surrounding the political landscape and the Brexit sequel. Yesterday, the UK government won an initial parliamentary vote on a bill that is set to override key parts of the withdrawal agreement with the EU. The pound did not react to the outcome, but we believe that the risks surrounding the currency's forthcoming direction are tilted to the downside. The EU has urged the UK to scrap the bill by the end of September, with the UK government refusing to do so. In our view, this lessens the chances of a trade accord before the self-imposed October deadline and increases the chances for a no-deal Brexit at the end of the year when the transition period expires. From Germany, we get the ZDW survey for September. The current conditions index is forecast to have risen to minus 72 from minus 81.3, while the economic sentiment one is anticipated to have slid to 69.8 from 71.5. Eurozone's wages and the labor costs index, both for the second quarter, are coming out as well, but there is no forecast available for neither release. Later in the US, we have industrial production for August and the American Petroleum Institute report on crude oil inventories for last week. Industrial production is forecast to have slowed to 1% month over month from 3%, while, as it is always the case, no forecast is available for the API print. We also have one speaker on today's agenda, and this is ECB Executive Board member Fabio Panetta. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.